How you doing?
Do you think it's possible to seek worship and fight child sacrifice?
I think so, definitely. But I'm just talking about what God says, you know?
Yeah.
That he actually hates the worship if you neglect justice and mercy.
Yeah.
So yeah, and the number one cause of death in our land is child sacrifice.
Yeah.
And most people, what they do, most Christians, is they have a good moral opinion. And they're actually even pro-life.
Right, but no action.
But no action. And the pro-life movement just regulates when, where, and how to abort babies.
Right.
And they actually oppose making abortion illegal. The pro-life leaders, like the Right to Life organizations, because that's where they get all their money to give to politicians, right?
Right, so it's sort of managing it sort of out of the public eye instead of sort of calling it what it is, which
right.
is murder.
And right, it's murder, yeah, right? Yeah. So all we're saying is, like I don't hate you.
No, I'm just curious.
And I don't hate anybody in here.
I know that. Yeah,
but what we're saying is woe to us when we neglect justice and mercy. Because God actually says, put down your stringed instruments.
Right. It's a time for mourning. It's a time for weeping. Yeah.
Well, and it's a time to bring justice to the land.
Yeah.
And, you know, God says it like he hates someone who moves a child's cornerstone, you know, and that's talking about property rights, right?
Sure. Yeah.
And then what happens
basically is saying that God has he has made provision for people. So if you're going to basically manipulate things to steal that away, like from whole, you know, family lines,
right.
basically the areas that God has made provision.
Right.
Woe to you who does that. Or when Jesus said to the Pharisees, like, you know, you tithe on
the mint,
dill
yeah.
and you know, yeah, and you have neglected justice.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally. And then what we've done is we said, like, this is a 21-week abortion, right? We've taken that cornerstone that you can't murder people.
Right.
And we said, Christians, pro-lifers, wrote laws that said, let's move that cornerstone up to 21 weeks. After 21 weeks, you can't kill a baby.
Right. But what about the first 21 weeks?
Yeah. Right.
I'm a musician. I'm a songwriter. And I'm really intrigued about the, you know, what is the role of art in changing
culture.
So yeah, culture.
Yeah.
And I think that nobody that I have encountered, nobody has been convinced through an argument, like, you know, sort of a direct argument. You know, you get political pundits that argue, nobody is convinced, you know. But what is the way to sort of come around behind the social consciousness through art? And so, you know, last year I wrote a song called 3 Weeks, and it's just what if the unborn child had a voice? What if he gave a voice to the voiceless? And that song is just basically saying, like,
and that's good to do.
You know, I have a group of people, you know, coming to a worship conference, and I want to know, how can art move this dialogue forward from saying, we're not regulating murder to after 21 weeks, but we want to give a voice to the voices, and we want to sort of use imagination
Well, then you're actually, like, working to bring justice.
Yeah.
To the you're trying to hold back those that are being led to slaughter, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
But what's like almost every pastor in our nation right now will say our nation's moving away from God, not towards him, right?
Yeah.
That's what they'll say, right?
Sure.
But we have churches everywhere, evangelical churches everywhere.
Yeah.
Why? How are we moving away from God? You know, like, God doesn't say, come up, like, in his word.
Yeah.
He doesn't say, you know, he doesn't come up with great songs. Like, Jesus didn't actually have a whole bunch of great songs that he came up and he spoke truth, right? And he told people to do what's right and told them to repent,
yeah.
right? So I'm not saying, like, songs are great. I love songs, you know?
I think that, you know, you have to operate within your giftings to a certain extent. Like, you know,
true.
So I think if I'm a bricklayer, I need to find a way to bring justice through my skill, you know, like, I don't
well, you may not bricks. Be able to, but you could work hard for God laying bricks. But then also you have to be a Christian and do that work also.
Yeah.
Like, you have to bring justice to the land. Like, sometimes a bricklayer can't figure out how he's going to make bricks bring justice to the land.
Right.
But he can go out to his representative and say, hey, look, stop regulating abortion. Let's make it illegal.
Right. Yeah.
And he can tell his pastor, look, why don't we say, let's make it illegal? When a bill comes up to make it illegal, why do we listen to Right to Life groups and do that? We need to stop doing that.
It's
we need to call them to repent.
It's not politically savvy to just say, let's make it illegal, but that is right.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
No, I think it's absolutely right. Yeah. I just was curious, you know, walking past, it's hard to know.
Yeah, we look like crazy. Like, I'm not saying you need to stand here with holding a crazy sign. But what we're saying is that if we repent of not caring, our apathy, then we'll know what to do. And the people go, well, what do we do? And the Bible says, oh man, you know what to do.
Right, generations of people right now recognize, you know, we look back and we judge previous generations and we say, how could they enslave minorities? How could they do, you know, how could, and we judge them.
Right.
You know, in the future, people are gonna look back at us and say, how did you go one single day while the pall of murder, you know, murdering the unborn, how could you just go drink a coffee? Yeah. How could you do that? You know, and that's a good question to consider.
Yeah. Well, and like these religious leaders here, like we asked if our child could go use the restroom.
Yeah.
And they're like, no, we'll arrest you if you step foot on our property. And it's like, look, we won't bring in signs.
Yeah.
We're just like, my kid has to go to the bathroom, you know? So then we got to go like over here to these buildings and, you know, I mean, it's like their hearts, because this is disruptive. We're agitating them, right? You know, it's like, oh, like, why are you doing this? We just want, you're ruining our event, which we're not ruining the event.
Yeah.
People go in there, they still have the event, you know? It's just some people are thinking, it is murder. It is wrong. You know, and a lot of people are getting the literature.
I think a lot of people.
You leaving?
I hate to be abrupt. I'm sorry, sir.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Love you, man.
Sir. Love you, man.
Thanks for coming
out. God bless you and for your good work.
Yeah.
Whatever he says, man, I pretty much agree. Okay.
Hey,
bless you, man.
Just as long as what I say lines up with the Word of God, you agree.
Amen.
Yeah. Because I'm Homer Simpson, like saved.
Yeah.
I'm like a saved Homer Simpson.
Yeah.
I'm still a dork. You know.
Well, so am I. Yeah.
So, yeah.
I hope a lot of people in this conference believe that abortion is murder, you know.
They do.
You know.
They do.
And so, you know.
Well, like John MacArthur.
Yeah.
He believes it's murder.
Yeah.
But he believes that we have to follow the laws of the land. And he believes that we shouldn't really be political, right?
Yeah.
Like, he's against actually making it illegal. Like, it's like two kingdoms.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, it's like, hey, if a cop says that, you know, it's okay to own black people, it's okay to own black people. We're not going to try to change that. We just preach the gospel.